Today, I want to talk to you a little bit about how we think about different expenses in our business, particularly taxes and savings. Yes, I said expenses in our business, and yes, taxes and savings are expenses. So often we think that's what we put if there's something left over. I mean, obviously not taxes, that's not when things are left over, but savings. We don't think about savings as an expense so much of the time, but what if we did? What if we said, every month, one of my expenses is that 10% of my revenue or 30% or whatever that is an expense that's going to savings. And then with taxes, if we look and see one of my other expenses is taxes, I'm going to be putting aside a specific percentage each month into a certain account so that when taxes roll around, I'm not blindsided and being like, crap, I forgot to save money for this and everything. You just know that it's an expense and you've set it aside. So you're ready to go. And it's almost like the money's out of sight, out of mind. When you have to pay it, it was never yours in the first place. So it's no sweat off your back. So the way to set this up, you need to look at how much you want to save. Ideally, you've got to have enough in your savings account to cover you for at least 3 months of any expenses you might have, including payroll and anything on top of that. So you need to set a goal to have a certain amount in that savings account. So you just calculate that based off of what you're typically paying in expenses per month. So that's your savings. And then you can break that down and say, okay, maybe in 2 years I wanna have that amount, or in 3 years, or whatever's reasonable. Maybe you could have that amount in like 3 months if you save a whole bunch. And then you just set aside that certain amount every month that is gonna go into your savings account. And eventually you'll get to that place where you're just like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I got here. That's incredible. I've got this huge chunk in savings. It feels good. And it's because you prioritize that as an expense. Same thing with taxes. You figure out how much you typically pay in taxes, and then you set aside a percentage of your revenue every single month into a separate account that you do not even look at. It's an expense. You paid it off and it's all done. Just like you're paying off a email or computer bill or instruments or whatever that is, it's an expense as well, and it comes out of your revenue. So I hope this is helpful to you. If you have any questions on how to set this kind of a system up, I'm happy to answer any questions. Email me at jc@musictherapymastermind.com. Or you can also join one of our mini courses on finance or our mastermind groups on finance. We go into depth in all of this, and I can't wait to share with you what we do. So hope this is helpful. Make sure you're paying yourself first and saving for the future. All the financial help to you. See you soon.